What's going on? Zay 101 here, and we are back with more Tales of Berseria. Apparently, one of my expeditions is. Oh. All right. Ooh. Really? Okay, never mind. And we got a cold red demon out there, man. Let's see what that guy's about. Let's go back. Francis. So does this mean Eleanor's gonna be with us? I hope so. Oh man. Oh, you're back. We should get some rest on. Alright. Stay awake.
I like how they gave you the option to stay awake.
Of all the things, a damned demon watching over me? How could I have let this happen? I'm such a disgrace. To atone for this grave sin. This is all I can do. Forgive me, Lord Artorias.
She's trying to kill herself in there. She on that bullshit. She's supposed to be helping him out. You trying to kill yourself. I hasn't woke up too. What is that?
Light. It's Melchior's communication art.
I send Melchior to check out the Earth Pulse. And what a strange sight does he find.
My lord, I have failed you.
Lift your head, Eleanor. The Shepherd has a special mission for you.
A special mission?
You are to protect the Moloch Lafiset and bring him to the Lobris Abbey headquarters. This mission is highly classified, and not to be shared with even the Legates.
Protect the Moloch and bring him to the capital, then?
With the utmost secrecy. Your becoming his vessel is in fact quite fortunate.
Maybe so. But with me as his vessel, the Moloch may interfere.
This Moloch may have his own will, but he can be manipulated. Do whatever it takes to get the job done, Eleanor. You act under my full authorization.
Even were it to mean obeying the orders of a demon? But, my lord, what Moloch could possibly be that valuable?
Are you saying you cannot?
Shame is only a fleeting emotion. It is will and reason that ultimately prevail in the face of calamity. My lord, I live to serve the principles of your teachings.
The Earth Pulse will soon close. From here on, you must use your own discretion to execute your mission.
Yeah, we're looking like.
You're up. How are you feeling?
I'm fine. Listen, don't try anything like that again. Pain is scary, right? I'm all right. No more running away. I'm Lafayette. It's good to finally meet you properly, Eleanor. Yeah, likewise.
Don't worry. If you try running, you won't get far. Once I've eaten your arms and legs, I merely need you alive to act as his vessel. Nothing more.
That won't be necessary. I swore an oath before our duel. An oath grants power in exchange for a certain constraint. Mine was, if I lose, I will obey my opponent. Once put in motion, an oath cannot be broken by the one who swore it. I will keep my promise to you because I must.
An oath, is it? In that case, I have a question for you. What does the Abbey plan to do with the Nominat?
To wipe out the demons, of course. We want to end the era of disaster once and for all.
And how exactly does the Abbey plan on wiping out the demons? Is the Nominat going to wander the land, slaughtering them all?
They never told me. And Nominat's ritual is kept confidential, even within the Abbey. All I know is that it involves Melchior.
And it looks like the only way we'll figure out Enominat's true nature is by deciphering Lafayette's book. We'll have to track down Mogilu's friend, the one who can read the ancient tongue.
If we go to Ysult in Southgand, we ought to find some clues to her whereabouts.
But first, we have to figure out where we are now. We need to find a settler or a village. Something.
I'm surprised us chuckleheads even know our own names.
Even the greatest scholars don't know everything at first. You can't get answers without asking for them.
Fair enough. Hard to argue with that.
I've never seen a Malak quite like him.
Eleanor, your job is going to be to protect Lafayette, even if it brings you into conflict with other exorcists. Because if you turn on me...
I know. Like I said, I can't betray you.
Listen, Lafayette. If she makes any strange moves, I want you to stop her immediately, okay?
I don't think Eleanor is such a bad person. Besides, she's oath-bound to her promise.
She's lying, obviously. That's only something you do if your life depends on it.
Yep. An oath is an art that takes complex rituals and lots of hard work and time. Hardly worth the trouble, to be honest.
I told you already. She wants to take you away from us. Women are creatures of deceit, boy.
If you say so. She's right. Of course that goes doubly so for Velvet the Vengeful Villainess.
Well, I won't deny it.
What is it, Lafayette?
I was told that women's looks can be deceiving, but I'm not sure what I'm supposed to see.
That's an age-old problem for men. You with me, Aizen?
Aye. Women are fickle creatures at best.
I remember
they
this.
Lie as easily as they breathe, and men can never see through their deceptions.
I totally feel you.
Sounds like you've both been through hard times.
The wounds women leave on a man's heart take longer to heal than a cut delivered by a sword.
It's that bad?
Beware a maiden's tears, boy. And guard yourself well. That's my advice to you.
Beware tears and guard myself.
Don't put any weird ideas into Lafayette's head, you two.
They're just facts.
Right.
If you fill his head with any more garbage, I'm eating both of you.
Yes, ma'am. Yikes.
The swordsman and the pirate having troubles with women? Ha! Well, women are nothing if not difficult. I have the deepest sympathy for you both.
What do you think of the ladies' reactions?
Well, Velvet won't eat either of you, and Mogilu didn't seem sympathetic at all.
See? Appearances can be deceiving.
And it seems you've absorbed the lesson well.
Right. I'm not like that, though.
Aww.
Huh? Yes, some women use their tears to manipulate others, but not all do, and I, for one, despise such duplicity.
The women who did that to Aizen and Rokuro are just the extreme.
Yeah, I can see how much you hate dishonesty, Eleanor.
Huh? Yeah, that's right.
Be a good example for the boy, then, so he doesn't end up like Rokuro and me.
I intend to do just that, whether or not you ask it of me.
Eleanor is a lot stronger than she appears.
Mm-hmm. So, we'll definitely shift her out. Oh, wow, look at her. She's
If I'm in this, I'm in this 100%.
I'm here. Let's do this together.
So, I definitely can't wait to try Eleanor out. She looks pretty cool. Wait, what about this? What about 32? Okay, so her eyes in and Mario leveled up with 32.
I'll finish this quick. You're wide open!
No, okay. What?
Out
of my way!
Come on, really?
I was just getting warmed up.
I'll show you the beauty of my power!
I won't improve by fighting weaklings.
There are none who can resist my spear.
That was crazy.
Huh? this stone?
It's just a rock. Take it if you want.
I think it's really rare. The way it sparkles, I think it might even be bright steel.
Bright steel? Never heard of it.
Yeah, it's actually a rare metal used to forge weapons and stuff. You don't find it just anywhere.
If there's bright steel here, that means we must be in either Endgand or Islegand. Both are a long ways off from Midgand. I doubt the Abbey has many people stationed out here.
That's our pirate! Arr! Here there be treasures shiny and sentries few!
At the very least, this could mean we'll be left alone for a while. Nice find, Lafayette.
Thanks.
Now wash your hands.
Okay.
The only way to learn where we are is to find someone to ask, I guess. What's eating you, Lafayette?
If people say you can't judge women at face value, does that mean you can with men?
Sure. Men are simple creatures.
Men are simple.
Oh! You talk like you're an expert in all things masculine. But you can only speak for your own family.
As if you're one to judge.
And I'm sure you've charmed a magnificent lord to be your lover.
Sure.
What does he look like? Is he tall?
None of your business.
Don't tell me. He was always on the other side of a swinging door, so you only saw his feet?
I see. What a lovely crush that must be. I read that story. It was a book called The Legs of a Man.
Oh? I've never heard of it.
I've read it too. It's a sad, bittersweet tale. But I enjoyed it quite a lot. I highly recommend it if you haven't read it.
Maybe when I have some free time after killing Artorias.
I just wanted to know if men could be judged at face value.
Oh my god.
It's not often you find bright steel above ground. I hear it's a lot of trouble to unearth, even in the regions it's normally found.
Yeah. Mining for minerals takes a lot of specialized techniques and experience on the part of the prospector. They examine the soil, the water, the plants, and so on, where the same mineral was found before, then search similar environments for the next big find.
Sure, but it's not like they succeed every time. It's all a big gamble. Isn't there a simpler way?
I read in a book once that you can use a pendulum to find water and metals underground.
It's called dowsing.
What's dowsing?
You hang the pendulum so it's facing the ground. Then you chant the magic word, magic kazam, and wait to be amazed.
The
little bit of ore on its tip will sniff out buried treasure and underground lakes like a bloodhound on a prickle boar.
You don't seriously believe this.
It's just like fortune telling. You win some, you lose some. That's why they call it prospecting.
So, if pendulums are used for fortune telling, why the hell is Zavid running around using them as weapons?
He uses wind to control its trajectory. I think it's easier for him to manipulate pendulums in a fight than something like a whip or a rope.
Oh, that makes sense now. That seems pretty clever.
He's probably also doing it to make himself stronger, too. Malakim broadly fall into four elemental types: earth, water, wind, and fire. Each strong or weak against the others. Wind beats earth. Zavid is a wind Malak. So when he obtains earth element minerals, his own strength is boosted.
I never realized Malakim could be so calculating.
Then if pendulums react to a Moloch's powers, maybe they can actually do this dowsing stuff like Magilu says.
Yeah, it's worth taking that thing seriously.
That is for real.
Zavid might like to joke around, but when it comes to fighting, he knows full well just what he's doing.
Oh my god,
he puts an awful lot of thought into that weapon of his, if you ask me.
Oh my god.
You don't?
I spare all my thoughts for my sweetheart.
Yeah, right. You just like to cause trouble without putting much thought
is
into anything.
Is this
the
real? I mean, it has to be, right?
I'll show you the beauty of my
firework!
Is this also part of the Reaper's curse?
Like, every death they give her some stuff. Oh, wow, she ain't messed up any of that. Wish she doesn't put her boots on, though. Pretty nice.
I'll finish this now.
If you want to live, get out of my way.
I'll finish this now.
Under pressure!
But I'm this close.
I won't miss. Form zero. Thunder.
Dragon.
Sorry to cut you down.
You there. Got a moment?
Gah! Are you guys with the Swordbreaker?
The who?
The what?
Get away from me!
What?
Yeah, let's go! Die! I'm sorry, alright?
Real class act. Attacking as you apologize.
My sword! Please, mighty demon, I beg you! I'll do anything, just spare me!
I only wanted to ask you something.
You don't have to worry. This woman here is an exorcist.
Huh? Right. I'm Eleanor, a Praetor exorcist. Please, remain calm and hear our questions.
You do look like an exorcist, but what are you doing with ruffians like these?
Top secret Abbey business. That's all I can say. Now, can you tell us where we are? And are there any ports nearby?
You don't know? You're on Cadnix Island in Islegant. The port is at the other end of that ravine.
I'll send a Sylphjay to the Von Eltia.
Thanks.
One more question. Who's this Swordbreaker?
Ah, he's a demon. Causes lots of trouble around these parts. He only attacks sword fighters, and he breaks their blades. He's even taken down a number of praetors.
Hence the name Swordbreaker.
He wields a fine sword, clearly forged in a foreign land. I tried to find his lair to steal the weapon for myself, but that's when I was attacked.
A foreign sword?
I'd be careful if I were you. If he spots that sword on your back, you'll be in a world of trouble.
Sounds like a real nasty fellow.
Well, he tries to pull anything on this demon, and he's in for one munchy crunchy surprise.
You folks are all crazy.
Either way, I'd say this is a blessing in disguise for you. You're lucky to still be alive. Take this chance to abandon your life of crime.
All right, burden the last sight. That's the ability to trigger random slow-related skills.
Can you read any of this old writing?
No. I've studied many languages, but I've never seen script like this before. Can you read it, Eleanor?
I've never come across this language either. Where did you find a rare tome like this?
Well...
It was a lucky find at the capital. What can I say? The kid loves to read.
I was surprised to see how many Malakim like to read. Pienfu does a lot of reading too.
I didn't know that.
It's true. I'm not sure what he's been reading though.
Did someone call for me?
Pienfu, do you like to read too?
Oh yes! Books are a treasure trove of knowledge! But I'm a greater Malakim, so the literature I enjoy might be a bit above your level, Lafayette.
Stop trolling.
How to talk a human female into becoming your vessel, and physically escalating with cuties.
Bien?
Physically escalating. What does that mean?
You really don't need to know.
All right.
Yeah, I'm confiscating all of these.
Oh my god.
And I have some questions. Pienfu, you better be ready for a thorough interrogation.
Bien!
Let's find that port.
Oh my god. Ha! Yeah!
You look like you're having fun, Rokuro.
I think this was another demo, too.
I'm a Yaksha.
A Yaksha? A spirit of war?
Yeah, a demon that lives for combat.
But this Swordbreaker has cut down exorcists with its foreign blade. Aren't you scared?
Of dying, you mean?
Yeah.
I'm not afraid of dying. It's more that I'm afraid of not being alive.
Huh?
Fighting is my life. It's all I want to do. So I fight. That's what living means to me.
Living only to kill. A demon is always going to be a demon.
Well, if you're gonna be blunt.
Okay, so this tradition just came back.
Take a look at this.
Oh my god, are you serious? Wow.
Scout ship setting sail. On to battle! Tougher than I would have liked.
Wow, so somebody subbed her in. Hey, I'm cool with it. You know, if she gets experience, then hey, I'm not ready. Oh, jeez. Okay, so we gotta check out that, that little red demon. There's no way I'm not gonna allow it. Ooh, look at that. Oh my god, look at that toe. Man, oh man.
A foe worth killing.
It was a close one, but I am the victor.
Clairvoyant Sphintite. Show the number of unopened treasure chests in a mini map. Ooh. Oh, this is gonna be awesome. Alright, status ailment slow. This is an earth element. Ailment. The drastic movement speed. While slow, HP can either be restored and quick spells are unavailable. Ooh, that's gonna be a problem. Earth-resistant enemies cannot be slowed, but enemies inflicted with reduced defense are 4 times more susceptible. Okay. That's a lot to remember with those, like you got physical attack, and people that are burned, more heart attack, are susceptible to being, burned and all that. Like, man, oh my god, that's awesome. So it's 3 unopened chests as of right now. Man, that's awesome, dude. That's awesome. That was a chest. Just wait, now okay. I messed that up, people. Oh, that's a save point. Alright, but we're gonna see what's going on with this chest. Ooh, that's a warp point. I wonder how to activate them. Just stand on them. So there's what? Oh, they're blue. Oh wait, no. Oh my god, that was a lot. Oh, stay away. Jesus. All right, guys. So I'm probably gonna end the gameplay here. And take a short break. And when we come back, we'll be back with more Tales of Berseria. So yeah. Alright guys, catch you guys later.